Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 10 in the PERT CPM. The topic for this lecture is Resource Smoothening and Leveling. Resource Smoothening and Resource Leveling. Learning outcome to the students. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to calculate the time and man hours by resource smoothening and resource leveling. So the definition for resource smoothening and resource leveling. So resource smoothening, the constraint may be total project duration and the demand on the resources is made as uniform as possible. So the project duration. So in the PERT CPM network, we calculate the TETL value and we calculate the total project duration. Now in the resource smoothening, the project duration you cannot alter. You cannot change the number of days of completion of the project work. That is what the project duration. But every activity, they require resources. Man hour, material, time. Time cannot be changed. Man hour and material. So in the resource smoothening, we have to adjust the level demand resources and we have to make as far as possible uniform demand of resources, the material and the man hour. In resource leveling, the constraint may be on the resource available. Say for example, the number of manpower available or number of man hour available is restricted. In that case, we can change the project duration. Project duration may be variable and based on the limited resources data, the project is rescheduled in the resource leveling. So resource smoothening, project duration cannot be altered. We have to smoothen, we have to adjust the requirement of resources. In the resource leveling, the resources, availability of resources are restricted. So we can adjust we can extend the duration of the project work. So we take one example and understand the concept of resource smoothening and resource leveling. A simple project has the following time and resource data as given below. Determine the project schedule. Find the project schedule if only two men are available. Determine the number of men required if the project duration cannot be extended beyond the minimum project schedule. So there are 6 activities, activity A, B, C, D, E and F. So for A, B, they are the initial activities. Without the precedence, they are conducted, A, B and D. For activity C, the preceding activity is A. For activity E, the preceding activity is B. For activity F, the preceding activity is C. The duration for each activity, number of days, 1, 2, 1, 5, 1, 1. And number of labor requirement for activity A, 2 labors are required. For all the other activities, 1 labor is required. So this is the network diagram. The network diagram for the project work with the TETL value and the slack value are shown here. So there are activity A, B, AB and D. They are starting from the initial event. So activity C, the preceding activity is A. For activity F, the preceding activity is C. For activity E, the preceding activity is B. So the network is concluded in the 5th event. And the critical path is calculated. Slack values are TETL values are calculated using the procedure what we discussed earlier. Now the slack values are calculated. So S equal to 0 for the first event, S equal to 2 for the second event, S equal to 2 for 4th event. S equal to 2 for the 3rd event and S equal to 0 for the 5th event. So the critical path is 1,5. So 1,5 is the critical path. And in the path 1, 2, 4, 5, there are 2 days of slack. Total float equal to 2 days. And in the path 1, 3, 5, again there are 2 days of slack. So the total duration of the project is 5 days. So the total duration is 5 days. The path 1, 2, 4, 5 has a float, that is slack of 2 days and the path 1, 3, 5 has also a float of 2 days. Now this is what the construction of the the original network and the corresponding resources. The diagram for the resources. The number of days equal to 5. How to construct the first diagram or how to calculate the labor requirement. So, the number of days equal to 5. So, you take 5 days. So, the watermark. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, each cell, each vertical line that gives 5 days. And this vertical line does not have any meaning. Vertical line does not have any meaning. So, the first activity 1, 2, activity 1, 2, it takes 1 day. So, first day, this is the 1, 2. Activity 2, 4, it takes 1 day. So, this is 1 day. Activity 4, 5, it is again 1 day. So, 1 day. So, there are 2 days float. The dotted line is shown by the, it is the float or the slack value. 2 days of slack value. And here 1, 3, so the activity 1, 3, it requires 2 days. So, the 2 days. So, first day, second day. The number shown here 2, 1, 1, there is lab record. Do not get confused. So, 2 days, I mean the 2 vertical lines in the x-axis. 1, 3 consumes 2 days. And 3, 5. 3, 5 again takes 1 day. So, 1 day. And you have 2 days of float here. 2 days of float here. So, for this diagram, the number of labor required. So, as per the given diagram, given the data, for the activity 1, 2, we require 2 labor. For all the other activity, we require 1 labor. So, for the activity 2, 4, we require 1 labor. For activity 1, 5, we require 1 labor. For activity 1, 3, we require 1 labor. And activity 3, 5, also we require 1 labor. Now, the counting the number of labor on the first day. So, first day, second day, third day, fourth day, fifth day. Number of days, 5 days. Number of labors required on the first day, 1. So, for this activity, 1. For the 1, 5 activity, 1. So, here 1, 2 activity, 2. So, 4 labors are required. For the second day and the third day, so 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. For the fourth day and fifth day, so the activity 1, 5 is continuing. So, we require only 1 labor. So, for the first day, activities 1, 3, 1, 2 and 1, 5, they are conducted. So, we require 4 labor. For the second day, activity 1, 3, 1, 5, 2, 4 are conducted. We require 3 labor. For the third day, activity 3, 5, 1, 5, 4, 5 are conducted. We require 1 labor, 3 labor. And on the fourth day, fifth day, activity 1, 5 is conducted, we require 1 labor. So, this is the initial diagram for the resource smoothening. Now, we have to adjust. So, you look at here, we have 4 labor at the first day, 3 labor on the second day and third day, and 1 labor on the third day and fourth day and fifth day. So, we have to adjust the requirement of labor by adjusting the float, So, look at this diagram. So, the number of men required, we have to calculate number of men required if the project schedule cannot be extended beyond the minimum project schedule. So, 5 days cannot be altered. So, once again, I look at the diagram. I take day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4 and day 5. 5 days. There is no change in the number of days. But the floats are adjusted. So, to minimize the labor requirement, the floats are adjusted. So, in the previous and the top of the line, the activity first activity flow on the top of the 1-5. So, we have 2 days float here that is shifted to the front. And again, 1-2 activity we require 2 labor and 2-4 activity we require 1 labor. 4-5 activity we require 1 labor. 1-5, the critical path is at the center. It require 1 labor. 1-3 activity for 2 days we require 1 labor and the float is shifted here. And 3, 5 activity require one labor. Now, look at the labor required. 1 plus 1, 2. The first 2 days, we require 2 labors. For the third day, we require 3 labors. So, activity 1, 2 and 1, 5, it is conducted. So, we require 3 labor. For the fourth day, we require 1 plus 1, 2 labor. And again, for the last day, we require 3 labor. Now, the requirement is adjusted. Requirement of labor is adjusted. So, first 2 days we require 2 labor, right? Third day we require 3 labor, fourth day we require 2 labor, and the last day we require 3 labor. So, the number of days equal to 5. There is no change in the number of days. and labor required, number of labor required is adjusted. So this is called as resource smoothening. So the days are restricted. So the constraint is on the number of days. We have to adjusting the requirement of resources. Particularly here in this example, number of labors required. Now resource leveling. If the project schedule is only if we have only two men, so what is the project schedule? So we require two men. We have only two men, and what is the project schedule? Now here we can extend the project schedule. Obviously the project schedule will be extended. Now here we are using the you are adding one day float. We are adding one. So we start the activity on the first day. We start the activity 1-2. On the second day, we start the activity 1-5 and 1-3, right? So the activity, it is 1-5 is continuing for all the remaining 5 days, and the activity 1-3 goes for 2 days, and the activity 2-4 with the 2 days delay, the activity 2-4 is started on the 3rd day and it is completed on the 4th day. Activity 4-5 immediately started, it is completed on 1 day, right? So here, the float is added. So slack period is increased. One day. So the number of project days are equal to 6 days now. So number of days are extended, but look at the manpower requirement. So it is only 2 men available. So using the 2 men, we can conduct we can execute the entire project. So this is what called as resource leveling. We can add slack. We can delay the activity by 1 day or 2 days depending on the availability of manpower, availability of resources. So this is resource leveling. So, whenever we execute a project work, huge project work, so there are certain, there will be, due to natural cause, there will be some delay in the supply of resources, there will be some problem in getting the required resources. In that case, we have to readjust our project schedule, and depending on the availability of labor, we have to allot the work and execute the project work. So, the concept resource smoothening and resource leveling will be very much useful when you execute your project work depending on the availability of resources, particularly men and the man hour. So we have to adjust the project. So minimum time we calculate initially TE, TL value. So minimum time you can reduce the minimum time by crashing the activity, or we can use the resource leveling and resource smoothening. The concept of resource leveling and resource smoothening, reschedule our activity depending on the availability of resources. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. There is one book, Operations Research. You can refer to it for additional information on the resource leveling and resource smoothening. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for a better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the subject Operation Research. Until then, bye.